Years ago, I was at this personal development event, and this guy walked up to me and he said, if you want to be a success, you need a life coach. And he handed me his card and walked away. I thought, wow, that is a direct sales approach, right? But I was intrigued just enough that I hung on to that business card. Because I was pursuing acting, and anyone in entertainment or sales or the creative arts or really any job these days knows that you're subjected to an awful lot of criticism or rejection, and you're constantly needing to get your mindset right and in a powerful way so that you can actually thrive, not just barely survive. So today I'm gonna give you 5 ways in which a coach can help you go from stuck to success. So my name is Sonia Satra. I was an actress. I was Lucy Cooper Spalding on Guiding Light and psycho nurse Barbara on One Life to Live. Not typecasting. But now I'm an executive life coach, an NLP practitioner, a health and fitness coach, and the CEO of Moticise, a company I created that combines mindset with movement. Because I found it's one thing to think about it, but once you get it into your body, into your emotions, anything is possible. So after many months of being rejected and starting to doubt whether I could ever succeed as an actress, I pulled out that business card and I called up this guy and I said, so I want to be a success. I'm interested in life coaching. And I started. And boy, was that ever a journey of a lifetime. I started to delve into the depths of my belief system, my values. I had a whole shift in perspective about what's possible. I learned all of my strengths and how to tap them in the moment when I really needed them. And probably equally as beneficial, I learned how to bounce back from rejection so that I could move to the next project without dragging all of that negative energy with me. And in 3 months, I landed that role of Lucy Cooper Spalding on Guiding Light. So yes, I am passionate about what life coaching can do for you. I've experienced it and I've observed it now as a coach. I've helped people do everything from lose massive amounts of weight to change careers, to fall in love with a life partner, to sell their company for 9 figures. Anything is possible when you get your mind, your body, and your emotions in alignment. When you tap that core power, that purpose, and your why, really, you can do whatever it is that you're wanting. So if you're feeling a little stuck or you're feeling like there is something more for me out there, life coaching might just be there for you. So what does it do? Why life coaching? So in coaching, number one, what we do is help shift your perspective, help you stand in a place of empowerment. So from there, you can take a look at, well, what could I do? What's possible for me here? So that's really number one, changing that perspective of where you're coming from so that you're tapping into what I like to call your body intelligence, that intuition, that knowing. Because really, at the end of the day, you do know what's best. You have the answers. They're just buried under that negative thought process going over and over and over. So we want to pull that out. We want to empower you to listen to that, to hear that, to get those answers and act upon those specific things that are right for you. Because ultimately, you do know what's best, and you will be your best guide. 2, capitalize on your strengths. We're gonna really highlight your strengths, which you're gonna start to learn and understand. It's so interesting when I look at, I ask people, what do you have? And they're like, nothing. You could see their whole body language just shifts, and they're just like, I don't know, I need this, I need this, and I need this. And they've got this big, beautiful dream, and yet they're coming to it from a place of, I don't have anything. And it's simply not true. Of course you have something. You have skill sets, you have knowledge, you have experience, you have contacts. Maybe you know people who know people. You have an awareness of what's necessary. You have probably endless things that you're not looking at. So really taking a look at what you have, what are your strengths, what do you come to the table with? And getting really comfortable with that too, practicing that. Because we're so used to practicing all the things we don't have and all the negative attributes. You ask somebody to write five things they're not good at, five things that they are good at, I guarantee you it's gonna be so fast on the things they're not good at, and the five things they are good at, they'll be like, like they'll really have to think about it. So making that be your go-to mechanism as opposed to the negative thought processes. So the third thing is, and this is perhaps special with a mind-body coach, is really helping you embody these beliefs. Because it is one thing to think things, and I'm all about coming up with thoughts, envisioning it, getting the action. But when you really start to get it into your muscle memory, into your body, you get to experience it, then you know it. And what else happens is it starts to rewire your brain. Because what we know about our brain now is that there are neural pathways and the brain will go to the place of least resistance. So if you're constantly thinking negative things or drudging up negative belief systems, that's where it's gonna go. It's like being in a forest, you know, that pathway that's beaten down. It's just gonna go the place where it's been beaten down. So if you're forging ahead on a new pathway, you're gonna have to start to create that neural pathway of possibility. And by getting it into your mind and getting it into your body, it happens infinitely faster and more effectively, because you're not just thinking your way there, you're actually feeling your way there. You're activating your emotions, and when you heighten your emotions, you're also heightening your vibrations, which starts to attract things. Suddenly you'll start noticing things will come into your life that never were there before. Or maybe they were, but you weren't noticing it. So that's really important, getting it into your mind and your body. Reflecting back. Sometimes you just need an objective person. Another thing a coach is objective. They actually do have your best interests at heart. And they can reflect back what they see without having any opinion about what you should do or you're not doing. They're simply stating what they're noticing. So there's no emotion involved. They're simply saying, hey, I know you really want to achieve this goal, but I'm noticing that you're using a lot of negative language. And I'm curious, what's that about? Did you even know that? Were you aware of it? Or is it just that it's become such a habit for you? And so in a really non-threatening, making you feel bad way, right? It's simply a reflection. Somebody who's objective, who can notice things and reflect it back to you. Because sometimes you're like, really? I was doing that? I didn't even know I was doing that. I didn't know that I kept saying, I can't do this, or it's really hard, or something like that. So we have speech patterns, we have belief patterns, we have body language patterns that will often be impacting our results, and we don't even know it. But a coach can be there to shine that light, to shine, you know, sort of mirror it back to you and say, hey, take a look at this. They also do that when it's good. So you get to see the difference. You can see it when, hey, this maybe we can course correct. Here, you got this, you're doing it great. See what that looks like, notice what that feels like. And that alone can be eye-opening and transformative. And finally, they're also there for accountability. They're there to really kind of, you said you wanted to do it. My life's not really gonna change if you don't, but yours really is. And I believe in you. I know you can do it. So they're throwing down the gauntlet, encouraging you. They're your biggest cheerleader, but they're gonna keep you accountable. and not like a good friend who might be like, don't worry about it. You could do it next week, right? You're like, hey, I know you want this. What can we do to make sure it happens? What's getting in the way? What's blocking you? Let's get rid of it so that next time you do make it happen. And slowly but surely you chip away at it. And what often happens with coaching is initially you break through those barriers and then it's like, phew, the floodgates, they open. And then all of this greatness starts coming your way. And then you start having success. And then maybe you hit another plateau because suddenly things are going so great. And you're like, I got to keep up with all of this stuff. Or you'll hit some new, higher, more elevated blocks. And then you work through those. But the level of escalation, the way that you succeed can happen so much faster, so much more fun, because you're doing it with someone who cares and someone who really wants you to succeed, and someone who can really reflect back your best self. And the more you step into your best self, the more you're going to be your best self. So those are some reasons why I really believe that coaching is beneficial. And it does matter who the coach is. It's really important that you have a rapport. So find somebody that you connect with. Who speaks to you? Who do you feel comfortable with? Who do you have a trust with? That's key. And timing. Are you ready? Are you really ready to move forward? Are you really ready to succeed? Because when you are, a life coach can truly help you make that happen. If you would like to know other information like this, any other mindset tools, mind-body exercises that you can do to really heighten your vibrations, help you attract the success that you want, that you deserve, to help transform your life, to achieve those goals that you really want, check out my website. There's lots of free stuff there, soniasatra.com. And again, subscribe, ring that bell. I'll be here often to help you because I truly, truly want you to thrive.